There are so many new areas of research that are exciting, from drug development to new delivery systems using nanoparticles. There's new equipment that we use in radiation oncology, fancy, quick machinery, and of course our new proton machine.
The Radiation Oncology Department at CentraState Medical Center offers virtually every potential radiation therapy option for our patients today. This includes what we call SMART-ARC, or 4D CT. All these are new technologies that really enable us to deliver more radiation therapy to the tumor and less radiation therapy to the other parts of the body that don't need radiation.
Proton therapy is a very exciting technology that we've just brought to New Jersey. And basically, if you think of the proton as a very tiny charged particle that goes into tissue, and then it acts like a firecracker. When it gets to its destination, the tumor, it stops, and as it stops, it explodes and gives off all of its energy. So it's a way of parking the radiation dose and damage right in the center of the target.
When evaluating treatment options for a patient, I think it's critical to really get to know the patient, and then obviously we focus on the medical decision making. And there's many, many treatment options for cancer patients today, and there's many hundreds of kinds of cancer. And so it's really very important to get a sense of exactly what sort of cancer the patient has and discuss all of the treatment options. We meet regularly with our other colleagues in medical oncology and surgery to collaborate with them and make sure that we're offering the patient the best therapy for their individual situation.
Collaboration of the team exists at many levels. We informally communicate with each other almost every day with patients. We also have a weekly tumor board that consists of all the members of the team, radiation oncologists, medical oncologists, surgeons, pathologists, diagnostic radiologists, social workers, nutritionists. Everyone gets together, a patient is presented, and then we come up with a team plan approach. So we get all the disciplines talking at the same meeting.
The differences between an academic center and a community hospital are that in an academic center, the emphasis is often on research and teaching, which certainly has a role. But at a good community hospital, you can receive care that's equivalent and equal to any academic center, but in an environment that's often smaller, more personal, and that's focused on patient care. The benefits, I think, of being treated in the community setting is that getting through cancer treatments can often be difficult, and being able to be treated closer to home, having the time to really get to know your physicians, not feeling rushed, being able to spend time with them, also having the support of your family and friends that are in the community and closer to home, I think can make the whole process easier.
When I get a call from a patient and they have a diagnosis of cancer, the patient's overwhelmed, their family is overwhelmed. So they call me and I'm there to help them find the right resources. It could be a medical oncologist or a surgeon or the radiation oncologist if they need radiation. I can direct them to the right place. I can help them find resources for financial needs, nutritional consults, rehabs, support groups, anything that pertains to their cancer diagnosis, I'm there to help them with. Once a patient is done with their treatment, we have a great health and wellness program here that helps them get back on track in their life. We have nutritional classes, we have yoga, we have Pilates, we have support groups, we have rehab. Whatever they need, they can find it here. We have a really good survivorship program.
I find radiation oncology to be a fascinating field. I truly love coming to work every day. I think the ability to cure people in a time of need, in a time when they're faced with a difficult diagnosis, is an incredible opportunity that we're given. Radiation oncology, we develop a long-term bond with our patients because many of them will indeed be cured of their disease, go on and follow with us for years and years. We often see our patients once a year for 5, 10, 20 years after they're finished with therapy. We get to know them and their families and have a special bond for life with them.